Well, when Kelly was a young kid, it was a family sport for us to go skiing. And she was immediately attracted to skiing. She loved the outdoors. She loved going fast.
It was just so much fun. Every level that I was at, I had a goal that I was moving towards, and you could never give it up because you could never quite reach the next goal. Skiing for Middlebury was always a dream of mine. The weekend before my accident, I had the best result that I had in a carnival, and I felt like I was just getting better and better. So the day of the GS at Williams, the top part of the course, I skied really well. As I came down, I came over a knoll towards the bottom of the course, and I remember getting spun around backwards.
It basically threw her off the side of the trail, and she hit a lift tower stanchion. And then I heard what every parent would never want to hear, and it was somebody yelled ski patrol at the top of their lungs.
I immediately knew that something was really not good. Her eyes closing and her breathing going short, and me just telling her, open your eyes and breathe. And that, it'll stick with me for as long as I live.
I never really had a moment where I realized I can't feel my legs, and it was really shocking for me. I was really injured. I had a collapsed lung. I had a bunch of broken ribs. Obviously, my back was broken, and I just had surgery on it. So it was a much slower process for me.
And as the pictures started to come into focus, it became clear for Kelly it was, you know, rehabilitation and not recovery.
Her attitude was just unbelievable. She never had kind of a sad day where she was saying, you know, why did this happen to me? Let's just get it done.
Kelly got back from rehab, started her junior year at college the following fall, and hit the ground running.
Kelly graduated Middlebury on time with her class, and she got a standing ovation from her entire class at graduation, which was a momentous event for everybody. And she kind of announced that I'm through, I'm living my life, and it may be different because I'm in a chair, but it's really good.
I would say 99% of the things that I want to do, I can do.
She's got a job as a nurse practitioner, she's married. Honestly, life doesn't seem like it's that different than if she wasn't paralyzed.
We came up with the idea of starting the Kelly Brush Foundation while I was still in rehab. After I had my accident, I realized, you know, this shouldn't have happened. I hit a lift tower and that should have been protected.
So the foundation really focused on trying to help every club around the country focus on safety and eliminate preventable risks.
So the other part of the foundation started when I was also in rehab. I realized how important sports were to me. I got to try equipment when I was in rehab. I got to try a hand cycle, and it was amazing. It made me feel like an athlete. It made me feel like myself again. But I found out how expensive they are and how prohibitive that is for so many people, and I wanted that not to be an issue.
It's an extremely powerful way of developing that sense of freedom that a lot of people with spinal cord injury feel like they've lost.
This accident happened to me, and I needed to do something good with it.
There's no question in my mind that ski racing is much safer for our kids, solely based on what the Kelly Brush Foundation has done.
I'd love to thank Kelly Brush Foundation, because without them, I wouldn't be up on the mountain and doing what I love.
The essence of the foundation is live the life that you want to live, and let's help you do that.